Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. I hope everyone is well there who's listening to this. This is Surah Zumar, which is the 39th Surah of the Quran, and this is ayah number 7, a beautiful ayah. And I'm just going to read it and give you an understanding of it and some other verses as well in this surah. It's a beautiful surah and it gives you a wonderful way of connecting with Allah Azza wa Jal. So let's begin. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم إن تكفروا فإن الله غني عنكم ولا يرضى لعباده الكفر وإن تشكروا يرضه لكم ولا تزر وازرة وزر أخرى ثم إلى ربكم مرجعكم فينبئكم بما كنتم تعملون إنه عليم بذات الصدور. Now, this is absolutely beautiful if you think about the meaning. It says, you know, Allah Azza wa Jalla says, He says, إن تكفروا فإن الله غني عنكم. If you are ungrateful to Allah Azza wa Jal, then Allah Azza wa Jal is in no need of you. He's totally independent from you. So basically, God does not need you if you want to show that you don't want Him. But the question then is, so does that mean that He's happy for me not to be thankful? He's happy that I be unthankful, I be ungrateful, and I deny this? Allah then says, وَلَا يَرْضَى لِعِبَادِهِ الْكُفْرُ. He does not like that His servants start to show ungratefulness or start to show disbelief. وَإِن تَشْكُرُوا يَرْضَهُ لَكُمْ. But if you are grateful and if you are thankful, then He will be pleased with you. وَلَا تَزِرُ وَازِرَةٌ وِزْرَ أُخْرَى. And no person on the Day of Judgment who can carry a burden will be able to carry the burden of somebody else. That will not be able to happen. ثُمَّ إِلَىٰ رَبِّكُمْ. Then only to your Lord is your return, and He will be telling you of the actions that you used to do, for He has knowledge of every single thing within your hearts or within your chests. Now, subhanAllah al-Azim, what this ayah is saying is that you can do what you like in this world. You've got free will, fine. Okay, humans like to talk about the free will. But what this ayah is ultimately saying is that you can't do any harm to God by denying Him, by not being thankful to Him. But if you are thankful, then He will appreciate what you've done. But don't forget, in the end of the day, when you get to the next world, there is no way anyone got their free will to save another person. So لَا تَزِرُ وَازِرَةٌ وِزِرَ أُخْرَى means that anyone in the next world who's going to start carrying a burden, their own burden is the only burden they'll carry, but they will not be able to take somebody else's sin and say, you know what, I'll carry this for you and I'll take responsibility for what you've done. So Surah 39, Ayah 8. وَإِذَا مَسَّ الْإِنسَانَ ضُرٌّ دَعَا رَبَّهُ مُنِيبًا إِلَيْهِ ثُمَّ إِذَا خَوَّلَهُ نِعْمَةً مِّنْهُ نَسِيَ مَا كَانَ يَدْعُو إِلَيْهِ مِن قَبْلُ وَجَعَلَ لِلَّهِ نَسِيَ مَا كَانَ يَدْعُو إِلَيْهِ مِن قَبْلُ وَجَعَلَ لِلَّهِ أَندَادًا لِّيُضِلَّ عَن سَبِيلِهِ قُلْ تَمَتَّعْ بِكُفْرِكَ قَلِيلًا إِنَّكَ مِنْ أَصْحَابِ النَّارِ. Now again, another striking ayah. Allah Azza wa Jal says that when the human being has got an affliction that befalls him, he starts calling his Lord by being so devoted to Him. But when Allah Azza wa Jal, after a while, Allah Azza wa Jal gives this human being a gift, and after He gifts him and He takes his difficulty away, the human being then forgets the prayer that he made, the du'as that he made beforehand to Allah Azza wa Jal, And then he starts to make other equals to Allah. He starts to think, well, you know, money and other things and other people, they're the things that can save, you know, save him, or he doesn't need God much. And these are the things that lead him away from the pathway of Allah Azza wa Jal. And Allah then says, enjoy your ungratefulness for a little while. You know, go ahead, go and be who you want to be, because you called me when you needed me. And now you want to show that you don't need me, so you enjoy what you want to do. Soon you'll be from the people of the fire. Because this is human nature. Human nature is that they want to show that, you know what, I'll call you when I want God, and when I don't need you, I'll decide not to call you after that. And subhanAllah al-Azim, this is putting your own nail in your own coffin. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. أمن هو قانت آناء الليل ساجدا وقائما يحذر الآخرة ويرجو رحمة ربه قل هل يستوي الذين يعلمون والذين لا يعلمون إنما يتذكر أولو الألباب. Allah then says, okay, now let's talk about the people who are not ungrateful to him. People who are grateful, who are they? But Allah says, the one who stands in the night time, or parts of the night, prostrating, standing as well in front of Allah, fearing the next world. Such a person, for example, they're standing in tahajjud, they're standing in the nightly prayer, and they are seeking and yearning Allah Azza wa Jal's rahmah, you know, their Lord's mercy. Allah says, do the people who actually know and the people who don't know, are they equal? Are those two equal? The ones who know, the ones who don't know? Well, only those people who are of great intellect and understanding, they will be the people who will take a heed from this. So what this is telling us is that the people who really, you know, show gratefulness to Allah Azza wa Jal, and who are people who Allah considers to be people who know something, are the people who will stand and prostrate in front of Allah Azza wa Jal for the things that He's given to them. Difficulties is removed and the gifts that He's given them. Allah Azza wa Jal says after that, قُلْ يَا عِبَادِيَ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا اتَّقُوا رَبَّكُمْ لِلَّذِينَ أَحْسَنُوا فِي هَذِهِ الدُّنْيَا حَسَنَةً وَأَرْضُ اللَّهِ وَاسِعَةً إِنَّمَا يُوَفَّى الصَّابِرُونَ أَجْرَهُمْ بِغَيْرِ حِسَابٍ. See, believers need to look at verses like this, and subhanAllah al-Azim, Allah Azza wa Jal gives us great guidance and you know, he gives us a lot of hope in verses like this. So this is ayah number 10 of surah number 39. And just listen to this. Allah says, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, say this to my servants. Say, O my servants who have believed, ittaqu rabbakum. Just be aware of Allah. Just carry on just thinking about Allah and be mindful of Him. For those who are excellent and do excellent reward in this world, for them is excellence in the next world. There's going to be a great reward for them and a great thing in the next world. And if you're having difficulty in one land or one area to actually please Allah Azza wa Jal, Allah says, "Wa arudu Allahi wasi'ah," the land of Allah, the earth of Allah is really, really expansive. Wasi'ah, it's huge. You got problems in worshipping me in one land, go and worship me in another land. But then Allah knows that there's going to be trouble for the believers, for those people who try to get close to Allah, who try to bow down to Him, worship Him. There's going to be troubles that they face. And Allah says this. Now, subhanAllah, this is the only ayah you will find in the whole Quran with this phrase, بِغَيْرِ حِسَابٍ, without any limit whatsoever, Allah is going to give a particular type of people some reward. He says, إِنَّمَا يُوَفَّى الصَّابِرُونَ. Those who are patient or withhold themselves or who start to practice Islam as they should practice Islam, you know, it takes a lot to actually keep yourself on Islam. You know, everything around you is pulling you away. So Allah Azza wa Jal, he says, those who have the patience or who hold on to the teachings of Islam, Allah says He will give them reward in full without any limit. This is unlimited reward from the unlimited, you know, God. That's a promise from Allah Azza wa Jal, that there's nothing that you could hope better than that in the next life. Nowhere in the Quran you will find that Allah gives reward like that, and He said that. It's only to those people who are patient, and I'm sure there are many, many people outside there who are listening to this, and they want to, you know, console themselves for what they're doing, and this is what Allah has told them. Okay? Now, a couple of other verses here. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. قل إني أملت أن أعبد الله مخلصا له الدين وأملت لأن أكون أول المسلمين. Now, subhanallah, Allah Azza wa Jalla, He says that He orders the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and He says, O Prophet, say this to these people. Say that you yourself, you've been ordered to worship Allah Azza wa Jalla, sincerely making His religion just for Him. That's just for Allah Azza wa Jalla. Allah then says, say to them that you've been ordered that you should be the first of those people who submit to Allah Azza wa Jalla. قُلْ إِنِّي أَخَافُ إِنْ عَصَيْتُ رَبِّي عَذَابَ يَوْمٍ عَظِيمٍ. Very powerful verse. Allah Azza wa Jalla says in verse number 13, He says, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, tell them that you, O Muhammad, tell them that you fear. Say, I fear if I was to disobey my Lord, I fear a punishment of a great day. A punishment of a great day. Now, this is our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam warning us. Can you imagine how we should feel when we read this verse? قُلِ اللَّهَ أَعْبُدُ مُخْنِصًا لَهُ دِينِي فَاعْبُدُوا مَا شِئْتُم مِّن دُونِهِ قُلْ إِنَّ الْخَاسِرِينَ الَّذِينَ خَسِرُوا أَنفُسَهُمْ وَأَهْلِيهِمْ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ أَلَا ذَلِكَ هُوَ الْخُسْرَانُ الْمُبِينَ. Allah Azza wa Jalla says, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, O Muhammad, say, it is only Allah that I worship with sincerity, and I give my whole deen, my whole religion for Allah Azza wa Jalla. So you people, whoever's against me, go and worship whatever you want besides Allah, because in the end, I've been told to say by Allah Azza wa Jalla that the losers are going to be those who lose themselves and their families on the Day of Judgment, and that is going to be, you know, beware, that is going to be their greatest and their clearest loss. The clearest loss anyone can have. Because if you don't turn to Allah in this world, then I'm afraid, and you know, this is the Quran telling us that your loss in this world is nothing compared to the loss that you're going to, you know, face in the next world. لَهُمْ مِنْ فَوْقِهِمْ ظُلَلٌ مِنَ النَّارِ وَمِنْ تَحْتِهِمْ ظُلَلٌ ذَلِكَ يُخَوِّفُ اللَّهُ ذَلِكَ يُخَوِّفُ اللَّهُ بِهِ عِبَادَهُ يَا عِبَادِ فَاتَّقُونَ. Ayah 16, Surah number 39, Allah says, for those people who have the loss on the Day of Judgment, this is part of what they will face. Allah says that for them there will be above them clouds of fire, and beneath them there are going to be whole clouds of fire. So this whole realm of fire above them, beneath them. And this is something which Allah Azza wa Jal uses to warn His servants and to make them fearful. Allah says, Ya ibadi fattaqun, O my servants, beware of me, be mindful of me, think of me. Now there are people obviously who are going to steer away from this. Okay? So what does Allah say about them? Allah says,
والذين اجتنبوا الطاغوت أن يعبدوها وأنابوا إلى الله لهم البشرى فبشر العباد.
Allah says, and those people who will stay away from anything that's falsehood, anything that's pulling them towards falsehood, and they only they won't worship those false things, they won't serve false things in this world. You know, there are many things that are false in this world that are pulling us. At the same time, they will only turn to Allah Azza wa Jal. For them, there is great, great news. And Allah says, O Muhammad, give my, Now, give my servants this great news. Which servants?
الذين يستمعون القول فيتبعون أحسنه أولئك الذين هداهم الله وأولئك هم أولو الألباب.
Allah says that those servants of mine, when they hear any speech, then they will take the best meaning of it and they will follow it. So they will derive the best of what applies to them and they will follow it. And Allah says they are the ones whom Allah Azza wa Jalla has guided, and they are the ones who are the real people of understanding.
أَفَمَنْ حَقَّ عَلَيْهِ كَلِمَةُ الْعَذَابِ أَفَأَنْتَ تُنْقِذُ مَنْ فِي النَّارِ.
Now Allah says, okay, now look at the scenario of two different people. There's one person who the declaration of Allah and the sentencing of Allah, punishment on the Day of Judgment for that person, has become incumbent. And Allah enforces that judgment on that person. Is he the same as a person who hasn't had that declaration or that punishment given to him? Are you, O Muhammad, going to be able to save anyone from the fire if they're in the fire? Because without Allah's permission, even our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam can't do anything. But then Allah azza wa jal says to us this. These are the great people, because that last verse in verse number 19, Surah Zumar, Surah number 39. What Allah is trying to say is that the good people, they're not going to be punished. They're going to be clear of all of this punishment. And Allah azza wa jal is going to give them this. Listen to this now. This is ayah number 20 of Surah number 39.
لكن الذين اتقوا ربهم لهم غرف من فوقها غرف مبنية تجري من تحتها الأنهار وعد الله لا يخلف الله الميعاد.
Allah says in this verse, he says, but those people who are mindful of their Lord, for them they are going to be, you know, like above Allah said that there's going to be above, the clouds above of fire, and beneath them there's going to be clouds of fire. These are people who are in hellfire. The opposite happens to the people of Jannah. And Allah Azza wa Jalla says that the people who are mindful of him in this world, they will have rooms above them there are other rooms. So you can imagine multiple rooms, one above the other. Mabniya, they've been made specifically, and beneath all of those rooms, there are rivers that are flowing inside. Now, some of you may wonder, well, how do rivers go through rooms that are above rooms? Well, subhanAllah, if you go to certain places that even in this world people have built in Dubai and so on, there are restaurants that are underneath the ocean. And you can see you can actually see the fish and other things that are above you while you sit in the restaurant. Allah can create things in Jannah which no human has ever even thought of. So you can imagine that the river actually flows underneath your floorboard and you can actually see it in Jannah. Might be a glass, you know, floor. You can see it. And Allah says, Wa'adallah, this is the promise of Allah. He will not break his promise. Now, this ayah tells us, the next verse is going to tell us, you know, this world, how quickly it's going to go by, and Allah wants to warn us.
أَلَمْ تَرَ أَنَّ اللَّهَ أَنزَلَ مِنَ السَّمَاءِ مَاءً فَسَلَكَهُ يَنَابِيعَ فِي الْأَرْضِ ثُمَّ يُخْرِجُ بِهِ زَرْعًا مُخْتَلِفًا أَلْوَانُهُ ثُمَّ يَهِيجُ فَتَرَاهُ مُصْفَرًّا ثُمَّ يَجْعَلُهُ حُطَامًا إِنَّ فِي ذَلِكَ لَذِكْرَى لِأُولِي الْأَلْبَابِ.
Allah says, have you not seen when Allah brings down from the skies water? Now that water is directed as certain, you know, to certain rivers, pathways, and so on. And it's going to go into the earth, and it goes all the way to what? To certain lands. And then because of that water, Allah will then bring out certain cultivation of many different colors. And then you will see that after a while, the winds will blow and you'll see that there's a yellowness because, you know, the whole seasons have passed by. This turns yellow and then Allah will turn it to stubble. In that, Allah says there is a reminder for the truly, you know, people who truly understand. Now, look at this, subhanAllah. Allah's trying to get us to think. Look, ayah number 9 says, ulul albab, people who think, who are really deep thinkers. Ayah number 18 is, look, people who are deep thinkers, ulul albab again. Ayah number 21, Allah again says, people of deep thought. He's trying to get us to think deeply. Now, how does this, you know, this example apply to us? Well, how it applies to us is, everyone of this life will start off with opportunities, and you'll have, just like the rainwater comes down, you'll have opportunities and they'll create for you many other opportunities, just like the springs of water, the different, you know, rivers of water and things will all go to a land and bring cultivation. Your opportunities of your life, whatever Allah's given you, will bring you greenness, and you will flourish with the greenness, and eventually you'll face what in life? You'll face yellowness, which is all your opportunities will slowly come to an end, and Allah will leave it as stubble, means that you will be dead. When the farmer comes, he just wants to take, you know, cut out what's his share and what he wants, and the rest of the stubble he leaves behind. And when Allah Azza wa Jal takes human beings and cuts them out from this world, he's going to leave you dead in the ground, and he's going to take your soul into the next life. Now, this is, you know, I'm going to come now to a part of Surah Zumar which I've been waiting for, and this is the final part, inshallah. And this will give us the whole, you know, way of Allah Azza wa Jal. What how does He want us to revive ourselves? Now Allah tells us here how He wants us to revive ourselves. Just inshallah to up to here we'll do. So two more verses, and then we're done, inshallah. أفمن شرح الله صدره للإسلام فهو على نور من ربه فويل للقاسية قلوبهم من ذكر الله أولئك في ضلال مبين. Allah says, what about the person whom Allah has opened his heart or her heart for submission to Allah? And they are actually on a guided path or a light from their Lord. Is that person the same as a person whose heart hasn't opened to Islam and who is not on a guided path from their Lord or on a light from their Lord? Allah says, woe to those people whose hearts have become hard from the remembrance of Allah. They are in a clear error. Now what Allah is trying to say from here is, first, you need to seek knowledge. That's how your heart opens to Islam. And second is you need to start to remember Allah Azza wa Jal as much as you can. This is dhikrullah, whether it's subhanallah, alhamdulillah, la ilaha illallah, allahu akbar, you know, la ilaha illallah, wahdahu, la sharika lahu, lahul mulku, wa lahul hamdu, yuhyi wa yumitu, wa huwa ala kulli shayin qadir. You know, any form of dhikr you can do, any way of remembering Allah, the more you do it, your hearts will stop becoming hard, and then your hearts will open to Islam. Otherwise, what happens is your hearts become hard, and they are the people who are in clear error. Now, look what happens when somebody's heart actually opens to Islam. This is the way to get true understanding and to get close to Allah, and this is the final verse we're going to do.
الله نزل أحسن الحديث كتابا متشابها مثانية تقشعر منه جلود الذين يخشون ربهم ثم تلين جلودهم وقلوبهم إلى ذكر الله ذلك هدى الله يهدي به من يشاء وَمَنْ يُضْلِلِ اللَّهُ فَمَا لَهُ مِنْ هَادٍ.
Allah says, Allah is the one who has brought down the best of speeches in a form of a book that has many different resemblances within itself, and it has, you know, dual parts that will reflect one part of the Qur'an with another part of the Qur'an. This is basically the Qur'an. Allah has revealed the Qur'an. And those people who actually really fear their Lord, they get goosebumps. Okay, they get goosebumps, and the skin, you know, the hair of the skin will stand up when they hear the Quran, and then their skins and their hearts, when they engage in the Quran, when they engage with the Quran, their skins and their hearts, basically the whole bodies will incline towards the remembrance of Allah. That is the guidance of Allah. He gives to whoever He wants, and whoever Allah wants to misguide, there is no one to guide them. Now, what this ayah is telling us is that if you start to study the Quran and you start to deeply reflect in the Quran, you will find that your hairs will stand on its end, because you will see that, you know, just like we've covered these verses, you can see how deep these verses are going and how much Allah is warning us of the next life. And all of this is telling us that you do the dhikr of Allah, everything will turn to Allah once you engage with the Quran. Once you have the remembrance of Allah, your hearts, your skin, your whole bodies basically will turn to Allah's remembrance. And that's the only way you will become the people of deep remembrance. So what we've covered here is, just give you a summary of this now and then we finished. Surah Zumar, Surah number 39, ayah number 7. It starts off by saying, you know, if you become ungrateful to Allah, Allah doesn't care. But He would want you to, you know, show thanks. Don't forget, on the Day of Judgment, you can't carry somebody else's burden. And then Allah says, in this world, this is ayah number 8 now, He says that in this world, you know, many human beings turn to Allah and He knows who they are. He gives them a gift and they turn away from Him and they start to make equal partners to Him. And Allah says, okay, go and enjoy the world. Go and enjoy for a little while. And then I'll see you in the next world. You'll be in the fire if you don't turn to Me. Allah says, the true servants of God, they are the ones who stand at nighttime, they prostrate, they fear the next life, they yearn for My mercy, and they are the true people of knowledge, and they're the people, true people of understanding. In ayah number 10, Allah says, O My servants, be always aware of Me, because in the next life I will give you goodness. My land is very vast, so if you have problems in one part of the earth in worshipping Me, go to another part, and I will give unlimited reward to whoever holds on to this religion and does their duties. Allah then gives several verses here to say that even Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is telling us that he wants to be sincere for his deen and for the religion, and he's asking us to be sincere for the religion. And then there's two warnings here. Number one warning, ayah number 16 here tells us that there's a warning of the fire in the next world if you don't, you know, believe in any of this. And ayah number 20 tells us that there's going to be, you know, rooms above rooms with rivers running underneath if you actually believe. Then Allah gives us an example to say how quickly this world will go by. Just as the farmer is looking at a green harvest and then there's yellow stubble, your life is wonderful right now. It's the greenery that you've got in front of you, but soon it's going to turn to yellow stubble. So what do you do? Well, if you want to turn to Allah, ayah number 22-23 tells us that your heart will open with the knowledge of Islam, and that your hearts may be hard if you don't do the dhikr of Allah or the remembrance of Allah. But if you do that, if you study the Quran, your skins, your hearts will all turn to Allah, and Allah will guide you to Himself. But if you are misguided, then there's no one to guide you. Jazakumullah khair for listening to this. I hope inshallah you make dua for me and for everything that you know we're trying to do for the religion. A link that I have put into the bottom of this title is the link to the app that we are trying to raise funds for. If you haven't yet donated or you want to donate more, please click on the app, the link. So sort of click on the link and donate whatever you can towards the app. It's going to help a lot of people understand the deen and get close to, you know, Allah Azza wa Jal through the du'as that they're going to make. And if nothing else, make dua and, you know, let us hope, inshallah, that we can practice these verses. Surah Zumar, that was Surah number 39. It was from ayah number 7 to all the way to ayah number 23. Again, a wonderful jazakumullah khair to everybody who has donated towards the Safar Dua app already. And may Allah Azza wa Jal bless all of you, bless your health, your wealth, bless all of your backgrounds, your loved ones, and give you the best in this world and give you the best in the next world. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.